There might have been a mistake with printing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm talking to the organizer. That's bullshit. Mm.
These are gorgeous.
I'll kill you.
This is beautiful. Yeah.
Okay. So there was a little bit of a printer problem at Eagle Man. I had to go run into the internet cafes are still a thing, apparently. It was 2016, for fuck's sake. Oh, talking of travelling back in time. There's some fantastically racist ornaments in the.
People. Did you see them? Everybody's like, yeah. You know, we were all fucking traumatized by those. Yeah.
It was amazing. All right.
I tried to buy them. I didn't think I could get them in my carry-on. So.
That was possibly the slickest entrance we could have managed. All right. So, welcome everybody to Glasgow Skeptics in the Pub. Sorry, Glasgow Skeptics in the Pub. So, Glasgow Skeptics is a grassroots, non-commercial organisation committed to promoting freedom of understanding. Science and understanding, critical thinking, freedom of expression, etc., etc.
So it is a science talk.
Guys, we should go. We're not, this is not for us. No. This is not.
Is there some kind of science box we can tick just by saying, Trevor, give me a science A word?
Say electron.
Drop the
ball. Hey, say it one more time. Yeah. Say it one more time. I'm almost there.
Anything with the word flagellate in it. All right, okay. So there, science talk done. All right, so can I have hands up in the air if it's your first time at a Glasgow Skeptics event? Okay.
Yeah,
true. You first timers, all right?
Definitely true.
Yeah. So you get you first timers probably coming here for the special entertainment, but can I just say that we run fantastic events pretty much every Monday night. In between now and Christmas, we go every single Monday full on. And usually they're much more sciencey.
But, in that they are sciencey at home.
We don't know yet. Okay,
we'll
see. Okay. All right. Okay. And tell me, is there anyone in the room who has never heard any of the podcasts that these gentlemen are in?
Oh, you poor people. Oh, go.
Okay.
It's only good in context.
Yeah, you should just go.
So bad.
It's not going to go well for you.
He's wearing a dress shirt. He thought it was a nice top. It's ready for a wedding.
Did you just see science talking? Oh, I'll go to that. Okay.
All right, just too polite to leave now. That's shit.
If you are going to walk out in disgust, just do it quietly, okay? Exit's here and here. All right. Nice one. Okay, I was going to do some other annoying fanboy stuff, but let's move on for that. So tonight, we are taking a departure from our usual format.
Yeah, you are.
To say the least.
And, you have no idea.
And we've got some heavy hitters from the world of podcasting.
It's because we're fat.
Some heavier than us. Yeah, sure. So to the far left, we've got Tom and Cecil from Cognitive Dissonance. Don't be fooled by the nameplates. Your icon's at the back. The foundation stone to the images there.
We're behind Skeptocrat. We release every week.
Skeptocrat, the new incredulous. Right, okay. Is that a sore point?
Super mean, bro.
We'll come to it later. All right, and okay, when we've got Eli and Heath and Noah from the Scathing Atheist. God awful movies and the occasional skeptic rat. So, can we please give them a ridiculously loud Glasgow Skeptics welcome?
Can I
mean,
don't do that to me. Don't do that to Eli.
Eli is just waiting for that.
So, since you guys were just performing, shall we say, in England a couple of days ago. How does the Scottish audience rate to the English audience so far?
Smells way worse.
Yeah.
No, I mean that a good way.
They're right here.
Don't tell him I said it. Okay. It was Eli.
He's going to edit that out before
I That's me, Tom! I don't like Scottish people! That's my impersonation of
what
Tom.
What I mean is I don't understand Scottish people.
Oh, I get it.
That's the same.
This guy gets
me. The river is nearby.
Yeah. There's that's the empty.
Does anybody have an English to gibberish translation device? Is that
okay? So yeah, we do have translators here for you this evening. If it all gets a bit too Scottish, we've got Megan here from Secular Society, Scottish Secular Society, and we've got Trevor over there. He's one of our very own people, and he's a.
You should just call.
He was deported from America some years ago. But he assimilated it well, and you know he'll be able to deal with it.
You and most of our army.
Okay. All right. So. for the evening, gentlemen, as I promised you in email, I've got some softball questions. Here
my favorite.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, but we're going to intersperse that with some other questions. And no, you might have to jump around a little bit. So at certain points,
I can't wait.
Oh my God,
we can jump to any of these topics. Okay, so we've got Scottish terminology, so that's going to help. Particularly since you guys are going to Edinburgh tomorrow.
I believe it's Edinburgh.
It's Edinburgh.
Edinburgh. Edinburgh.
I read it on a
Edinburgh
map.
Tomorrow,
Edinburgh.
Okay. We've got a couple of questions about religion in Scotland.
Pass. Yeah, pass.
A book review or a book. Ooh.
Freedom!
Isn't that your guys' thing?
Yeah.
When do I get my kilt?
Who throws the claymore again?
We're going to do some critical drinking, and there is a section at the end there called Oprah or Chopra. Now that is that is a leftover relic from an event we had earlier in the year that we never used. So we figured, if things aren't going well, we go Oprah or Chopra.
Feed the leftovers to the Americans.
There's no leftovers when there's Americans around.
Think of that as the Joker card. We're going to play that if things are going badly. Okay.
Puerto Rico's our leftovers.
Right, okay. And in addition to that,
U.S. principality-based jokes.
They're colonized. They get it. They get it.
All right. There's a Twitter hashtag up there as well, so people of the audience. I don't know if there's fucking Wi-Fi here or anything, but if you want to do a bit of tweeting, the hashtag is Glasgow. Okay. Hashtag Glasgow for this evening. If you have any comments or any questions, etc., stick them on Twitter, okay? We've got Graham over there in Twitter corner. Wave from Graham. Woo. Ooh, whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's hear it for Graham.
Graham! Yeah! Okay. Love that guy!
Don't get too excited. Okay, so if you happen to say anything particularly amusing, then Graham's going to give me the wave, okay? Otherwise, we'll bank the questions and we'll go to audience Q&A at the end. That seems fair, is it not? All right, okay. So Graham, give me the wave if need be, and we will have time just for standard Q&A as well at the end, depending on how well all this shit goes, okay?
With us here now,
I don't think we're getting past critical drinking.
Well, we'll get that in
early,
don't worry.
Critical mass is the problem. Yeah. Science joke. Science joke.
Science
talk. Okay. Science talk, it's over.
He gets it.
So let's start with the softball questions. Gentlemen, can we have your impressions of Scotland so far?
The inside of my hotel room was awesome.
Look at me, I'm Scotland. I'm a little country that's kind of attached to England. Are we an island? No, that's Ireland.
That's a great Scottish impression.
Impressions is a homonym, and it also means to make fun of something. Right. I'm hilarious.
Okay. Anyone?
I mean, it's the 4.5 hours we've been here have been stunning.
Absolutely.
It's stunning. Actually, they have been. I would go back. Not today, though.
Yeah.
No, not today.
Okay. So, wrong answer from all of you, but the correct answer is better than England.
All right.
Are we not in England?
Just ask the English.
Looking for an escape. I don't
know if we're going to get out here alive. Okay.
I don't know any of these people.
All right, well, I'll tell you what. For the people who have never heard any of your podcasts before,
why don't you give us, I guess
Tom and Cecil start with this, why don't you tell them a little bit about cognitive dissonance?
We're a comedy show, not a science talk show, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's for sure. We cover American politics and skepticism and
religion
a lot, because in the United States, they like to shove religion down our throats, and so we do a secular podcast, and I don't think is that a problem here? It can't be a problem here, right? You guys are pretty secular, right? Applause if you're secular. Huh?
You are. You get it.
They get it.
You know,
they
get it. If you're religion.
Yeah. Yeah, that guy wasn't applauding. You can go.
Okay,
security.
Graham, bouncing.
Okay, Eli, Heath Noah, tell us about your many podcasts.
This is 100% your job.
our primary show is The Scathing Atheist. It's basically, it's like cognitive dissonance, but organized.
That's true, actually.
We also do a show called God Awful Movies, where we break down Christian and pseudoscience cinema. And occasionally we do a show called The Skeptocrat, where we take shit for not having a better release schedule. I'd say that's pretty much it. That and a lot of cussing.
Okay, so Skeptocrat then, despite the cheeky comments, is it going to become more regular, or are you just going to keep it around the sort of presidential debates and such?
Well, we've sort of reached a point where American politics have spoofed themselves to the point where we have nothing to add. So we're waiting for things to calm down a little until more humor is needed.
At this point, all episodes of Skeptocrat are just like, and then this person said this, and we all listened. And none of it was illegal.
Now the news is just the Skeptocrat.
Yeah, exactly.
Just watch Matt
Anderson
news.
Cooper's beating us to us, just drinking at his desk. You know, I remember when Nixon and Reagan were the bad guys. You all remember that? I'm gay. Gay. He is.
In the increasingly incestuous world of podcasting, you guys have made guest appearances back and forward on various
a reach around is only polite. That's
it is the way to do things.
That's nowhere near the most incestuous we've been.
Well, you're from Georgia, so it's like that's a thing. That's a whole thing.
No, I'm
and
not.
If we're fluffing it up here, you know, we just did a very incestuous thing back and forth and raised $25,000 for Modest Needs. So. We really didn't do anything though. I mean, we just wrote dick jokes. Everybody else paid the money.
Thanks for preempting my next softball question.
Oh.
Tell us a little bit more about Vulgarity for Charity. What was it about? What did you guys do?
It's not our idea. We just tagged along.
So Vulgarity for Charity is a charity that we've done twice so far. So one of the things that sort of we specialize in across our shows is making fun of people, especially their physical appearances. One of the ways that we talk about are this sort of elevator pitch, especially for our show God Awful Movie, is it's a roast of Christian movies. I don't know if you guys are familiar with like the Dean Martin roasts. But that sort of, or Comedy Central roasts, that sort of very roasty, making fun of no holds barred humor. And a lot of the time, our listeners would write in and say, oh, you gotta do me, or oh, you gotta do Pat Robinson, or something like that. And so we decided we were doing a charity fundraiser because we had some guests on last year who were for a charity called Songtaba, which actually helps women who are accused of witchcraft. And their guest came on, and it really just was such an incredibly meaningful story that he told us that we wanted to raise some money. And at the time, I was not full-time on Scathing Atheist. I was just sort of a sometimes guest. And Noah called me, and he said, look, I want to raise some money, and I think one of the ways to do it is if people give a certain amount, you'll insult them. And I was like, yeah! Let it begin. And so we ended up raising
It was $18,000 for us.
We raised $18,000 for them, and we realized that our listeners, as usual, are among the sort of best people we could ask for, but the only thing we could ask for is the two funniest people that we knew, which were Tom and Cecil.
The other people declined. No, that we were.
That's true.
The two most
And so we got together, and this year our charity was Modest Needs, which is a U.S.-based charity that's a little bit like GoFundMe, except the thing that's really great about it is they vet the people who ask for funds, and they also make sure that their debt goes to the thing that it is, because sometimes, you know, people borrow from their rent and then oh, they realize they needed that money for this, that, the other. So we raised $25,000 for Modest Needs. Actually, Cogdis just released our interview with Keith, the founder of Modest Needs today.
Incredible human being.
I cannot recommend listening to it enough to hear just sort of his story and the extraordinary stuff they do with the money there. But yeah, we did a $25,000 in a week and a half, 2 weeks.
What is that in pounds? That's like
that's $67,000.
Well, after breaks, $1 million.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
I don't know what the ratio is.
It's
not
several wheelbarrows.
I have no idea. I did get changed today though, and it's multicolored here.
Oh shit!
Yeah, they can't even decide what color it should be. It's just.
I felt like such an idiot standing there at the store trying to figure out what's what. You know.
I just gave it back. I was like, I don't know what this is. You can have it back. Like, can I have money back instead? This isn't for me.
Okay, round of applause, please, for the great charity work. All right, excellent. We've had enough softball, and should we launch into some hardball?
Hardball.
All right.
I like it hard.
Let's go. Let's go Scottish terminology. Okay. No, so as I say, this is.
I'm going to do really well. I feel really
okay. So maybe I'll take you guys one at a time here. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flash up a word on the screen.
You're going to take us one at a time.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
Double up, big boy. Double up. This could take a long time.
There's
five of us.
Oh, he's eating them. Okay.
These are living beings.
And what I want you to try and do is I want you to try and pronounce that word.
Oh, I'm going to fucking kill
this. And I want you to try and tell us what it actually means, okay? Alright? Okay, so, well, let's start with Tom.
Okay.
Go ahead, Tom.
They know.
Oh, I know this word. Actually, that's pronounced haggis. Haggis, I think that's right. Did I get the mic? I'm right there, right? Haggis?
Yes.
Queen. The queen. No? That's the wrong
thing.
No,
it's the wrong thing.
I feel like, is that the wrong thing here?
Should yeah, my, call the swans.
Okay. Right. I got
the swan. Hey, you guys want to try
can somebody steal? Is there a buzzer?
I'm going to steal.
Yeah.
I'm going to steal. I'm going to say that that's pronounced stunner. And it's when you really like a movie or a band, you're like, oh, they were a stunner.
No, that's actually the stunner.
Dressed up guy gives me points.
Yeah. No, I actually know.
Dressed up guy wants to give you a stunner, but
it's, that's the stunner, and that's where the finger goes in without permission.
That's the shocker.
Can someone in the audience tell us what a stunner is, please?
A stunner.
Yeah.
I still don't know.
Okay. We still have no idea what it means.
It means stunner is another word for an erect penis. Specifically an erect one. Wow. Okay.
Not familiar.
Why didn't
familiar.
You use a baby carrot?
Not familiar.
I don't get it.
Why is it sliced up?
Why is it sliced?
Yeah, what's happening in Scotland? It's fucking chaos here.
Do we have any intactivists here? Let's get into this.
Over-enthusiastic circumcision.
How do you procreate?
Okay. Look, this is my work machine. I'm not allowed to put real props on. All right. So other words include walloper. Okay.
Walloper.
Dobber. Or the best is booby.
Is there a booby. Disappointer? Is yeah. there a disappointer?
Okay.
They call that an American.
Now they don't necessarily mean erect penis, but they could. You know, they can use, okay, especially the term booby you use with the word the in front of it, usually along the lines of,
you gotta have a definite article.
She loves the booby.
Oh my god, it actually says it as
science talk. We're having a science talk. Yeah. Right? Science talk. Just want to emphasize.
Exactly.
That's like a thing.
Okay, let's move on. Okay, Eli, this one's for you.
Okay,
go.
Ball where? Bar.
It's baller, dude. They just misspelled it. It's baller.
Okay. Any other guys want to pitch in?
No.
Well, I feel like I'm learning the cadence. You start off, but then you kind of quit at the end of the sentence, at the end of the word.
Yeah.
Bay.
Okay.
Bay.
Do you have any idea what it is?
Oh, Lord, no.
I no. swear baby Jesus was born. In a bar. All
right, okay. Okay.
You should grab that.
Does that help?
In no way. In no way.
Shut the fuck up. Now they're just fucking. Oh,
yeah. I know, runny guys.
It's interracial gay relationship.
All right.
I hope he's right. I hope he's right.
Okay, this is science. Ball hair is actually a unit of measurement. Okay? Anyone? No? No? Okay. Does that help at all? Is
ball hair?
Like arsenic?
Is this ball hair?
Does it mean buy a hair?
A specific hair.
Yes.
An RCH.
Sorry?
An RCH, is that not a term?
Yeah.
Is there RCH? Ball hair?
Red cunt hair.
Red
cunt hair.
Okay.
Again, it's ball hair, but you guys are just fucking mushing your words together.
I have so many follow-up questions. Yeah. You guys have the word ball. You have the word hair. What? How quickly did you need to say ball hair that you felt the need to combine them? Quick, grab him by the ball hair. God, he got away. We need a way to make this faster.
Yeah. That's not a Scottish word. That's a speech impediment.
This is how we have Jews.
So this one was especially for you, Eli.
It's just mispronouncing it.
So boss?
It's just mispronouncing the word.
It's pronounced boss, alright?
You just mispronounced it.
And if you add
it... country's ridiculous.
...with the word nick...
I love it here, it's beautiful.
...to accidentally cut, you get Eli boss.
So wait, that's your work computer. You can have balls, but not a dick.
No, there's a dick there too. He's on the left.
Oh!
I
he never said where he works. That's the thing. He never said where he works.
Yeah. Those aren't real. It's a little graphic. It's fine. I can get away with that. Yeah. But so yeah, your surname forevermore, Eli, is evocative of a sort of a manscaping accident. Okay. All right. Let's move on. Okay. We're gonna go to.
Oh, this one we get.
Yeah.
Let's go to Heath for that one.
Yeah.
All right. Cute. I got that pretty close. That was fucking close.
I know what this is. It's like an orange vegetable.
Well, a pound of carrots, please. No, Does he went for that one? Is that acceptable?
Do I get points?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Carry
it.
That.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, Packy store.
Whoa.
Wait, what the fuck is shit? Did I say something mean? I didn't. What?
Did you say just package?
Yeah.
Package. Oh.
I have no
hilarious cultural difference.
You just said a racial slur, and I could not be happier about it. The mean
what
thing.
What the fuck is that? What did I say?
In the antique shop back there, they say that sort of language. Okay. All right. Okay.
I still don't know why what he thought he said was wrong.
I still don't know either. Why
I have no idea what happened.
I'm racist all over the world. I can't.
What word did I almost say that's racist?
It's the not nice word for gypsy.
Can we explain that one? Yeah. Okay.
Paki is a pejorative for Pakistani.
Yeah, it's an abbreviation.
Oh, I did.
For
I was trying,
do they normally sit in like?
No, I get
bags?
It because they would have a convenience store, so it would be a Paki store. Am I getting there?
Let's really dive in.
I'm
on
trying
this
to understand.
How racist is dropping the N word here? You just gotta chill.
How racist
you
are
chill.
All the racists?
Chill.
Are some of your best friends?
I'm just trying to understand. Look, I'm not the one that had that picture in your shop window down the road, right?
Yeah, no one's walking out. Oh,
yeah.
Is he going for a piss or is he what he's walking out?
Oh. We almost the spoilers right there. Try harder. Yeah. Go for the N word next.
She's walking out.
All right. He's like, I'm going for a pee, and it doesn't go to the toilet. Yeah. All right.
I have no idea.
All right. So,
if it was anyone else, that would be.
Let's see if we can tap
the
racism.
Also, there's a carrier. Okay, so if you are going to a party or whatever, and there's not going to be a bar there, you buy some drinks and you carry it. Carry it.
Okay.
So, if you guys are going back to your apartment tonight, the pubs might be shut by then. I would suggest a carry-out in
Got
order
it.
To make sure you don't go.
Can we name like a few more racist terms so I don't? Just so I know ahead of time.
Yeah, sure.
Just like
shout them out.
This is a judge-free zone.
Yeah. All right, fuck, let's move on before we get arrested, okay.
Fuck you.
Let's go to Cecil for this one.
Oh, that's what you get.
Can I buy a vowel?
They must have Wheel of Fortune, that's amazing.
Pull the audience.
All right, so
pull the audience.
I was cruel, this is us.
No, hold on, I got this one.
Okay, go.
Hachoo!
Surprise, I know you're closer than you meant.
That's clearly trebuchet.
Yeah.
From the audience, please. Chukta. Yes.
Wait, one more?
Chukta.
No, pass.
Okay.
This one is a racial
slur. Even after you said it.
Chukta. Okay, so chu as in chu.
As in a noise you've never heard.
Right? It's
what's
it's it's pronounced chucha like. Chucha.
Scotland. Scotland. Yeah.
We're doing
it.
We're doing
it.
It's here.
Okay.
No, man.
I could have softballed you and given you the slightly easier spelling, but figured it wasn't going to make a difference. So.
Oh, yeah, that would have helped. I wish you would have given me that one.
Do it then.
Yeah, I know. I would have recognized it right away.
Do you know what it is, anyone? Audience. Whoa. One at a time.
What did you...
What the fuck?
Oh, it's a person who has sex with animals.
Why do you have a specific word just for that?
No, not necessarily.
Is it coming across? Is it that needed that you can't just go with sheep shagger?
They may or may not be sheep shaggers, but it really depends where they come from. Anyone else?
What, a yokel thing, so?
A yokel, yeah, exactly. Okay, so.
Yeah.
Maybe. Does that help? Okay. Yeah.
I saw that guy. I saw him earlier.
That's from
Is it Brian something?
He bought me a pint.
Is it Graham? Might be Graham.
Yeah, that's the one. Okay.
Realize.
All right, no, you're last. I saved this one especially for you.
Karis had to be
cute.
Oh, you. I'm glad someone finally said those for me.
The mic's alive.
I'm going to go with cunt. And I'm going to guess that means. The thing that theoretically has a clitoris nearby.
Theoretically, skeptic.
Okay.
Theoretically, science talk. Right?
So, does anyone want to sort of pronounce it a bit more Scottish, please? There you go. The T gets lost a little bit. Right. Okay.
Again, you guys quit at the end.
All right.
At the end.
And unfortunately, your description was wrong as well. It's not the correct answer.
Oh, no.
In Scotland, a cunt is a person.
Well, they, some of them do have clitorises, theoretically.
Oh,
okay.
Feminism,
so
just call anybody a cunt, right?
No, no, I have to interject, because I think cunt is pretty much nearly anything in Scotland.
Wait, I'm way more interested in your country.
American?
I'm never leaving.
It's a word for thing.
It's a word, yeah, it's a thing for stuff.
Yeah, it's a term of endearment. If you say, oh, he's a good cunt, all right? I know! Yeah, shocking, is it? So, would you like to hear a Scottish person swearing, saying cunt on national television?
Yes, right now.
Absolutely.
All right.
That's the most offensive word you can use.
I know. Are we on national television?
Yeah, it really is. It's the most offensive word you can use.
Now, two things. I was having problems getting this to play earlier on.
In America, that word is only for people who hit women.
Yeah.
That word is actually so offensive. When you hand it off to Noah, I was a little relieved. Yeah. And I like to be offensive. It's kind of my jam.
I'll see if I can get us to play. It wasn't running earlier on, but come on, baby.
You are such a tease.
That's amazing. Oh,
cunt.
Yeah.
I'm gonna call everything here a cunt.
I just like I could say that worry free here.
It says it's playing.
No, it's like a superpower here.
That's amazing.
Come on, fucker.
They have super-powered cunts here. I'm never leaving again. I'm never leaving. Never.
It was a minority. It spoiled us for the last time. And this time it's going to be a game of football. Every cunt's going to be.
So, I'm sorry. Did he say cunt in there somewhere?
Yeah. Sure.
What just happened?
That's not.
Hold on. He's going to do it again.
It spoiled us for the last time. And this time it's going to be.
No.
That's not a word.
No. No.
He's not wording.
Can you subtitle that, man?
He said it's going to be, last time it was a spoiler, but this time it's going to be a good game of football, and those cunts are blah, 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 blah.
You're in, dude. You're in. You're in.
So he's going to have a good time. He gets it.
Jesus. Yeah, all right. So, yeah. I'm
going to need people to walk around with a chalkboard and just write shit down.
How do you know about all this stuff, like, they're saying in racial slurs? You have a lot of knowledge.
Jews learn to pick up much more quickly. Because if you don't know what everyone else is saying, they're like, oh yeah, there's showers over there. I don't speak much German. You guys didn't hear about it. There was a whole thing in the 40s.
So that was, it was on English television, which is why it made it on air. The English did not spot that, because just blink and you'll miss it, or your ears and you'll miss it. So,
listen and you'll miss it.
Yeah.
Study it in college and you'll miss it.
Okay. So I want you guys to try and remember those words. Use them as many times as possible, especially in Edinburgh, okay?
Okay.
All right, go.
Especially the one he said.
All right. Round of applause, please, everybody. That was a good start.
Have you guys considered using a language to see if that would help?
No.
Do you want to pick a category next?
Yeah.
Critical drinking.
Critical drinking. All right, what a surprise.
Says the teetotaler.
Okay. So.
That was very clearly.
So the Glasgow Skeptics budget is limited, okay? In an ideal world, we would have had some beautiful malt whiskey for you guys to try and sample and give us your opinion, you know, in front of the microphones.
Lovely.
The cheaper option is going to Scotland's second national drink, okay? The alternative national drink, okay?
Riding alcohol?
Have you guys seen or heard of this before?
Earnbrew?
Again, I'd like to buy a vowel.
What? Is that hyphenated? Is that, or is that just?
Yeah, it's a hyphen, yeah.
So the first word is.
I'm gonna say something racist.
What if 40s like big words for old women?
They're like, that's not enough. But that's the dark one.
So this
what does the light one look like?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, it's gotta be. It's just water. It's just water.
It looks like old English.
Yeah, I know. It's old E.
Okay.
Oh.
So we're gonna do a live taste test here. Okay.
I like that it's a little warm. That's good.
49 pounds. That's like a dollar.
49 cents.
This is a 50-cent beer.
Of cents. Brewed in Scotland, a secret recipe
Eli,
since 1901.
The Iron Brew website says it's vegan-friendly. I believe you're safe.
Sure.
Okay. All right.
It's friendly. It's not vegan.
Yeah.
Sure, anyone can have one.
No. We'll be nice to you while you get sick.
So go ahead, crack it open, and
Should we give it a little?
Oh, sure, yeah. Clean your palate and everything.
Do I want that rocks or no?
Do you have some, like, I want to cleanse my palate.
What the fuck is that? I like it. It's sort of orangey.
You are. I'm gonna hate it so much. Get in it. As soon as Eli's, oh, I like it.
It smells like baby.
It's like creamsicle.
Do you have some rubbing alcohol I can cleanse my palate with afterward? Just to.
All right. Cheers.
Oh God.
Yeah. Cheers.
To Scotland.
Oh, that's horrible.
Oh my God.
Oh, it keeps happening.
Oh my God. Oh, it tastes like something. No, it's not creamsicle.
No confidence.
Why would you buy this with money?
Sounds more like coke.
You know that? Why would you buy this? You know that feeling you get right before you're gonna throw up and everything tastes like bile and like that blood? This is a little worse than that.
It's not alcohol.
There's no night that has ever ended well that's involved more than one of these.
It's safe.
I know, but I think everybody thought I drank some already, and I was just gonna like
it's
not.
Come on!
I would call it a lot of things, but not safe.
Swallow. That actually outsells coke in this.
So bad.
You just don't want other people in your country. I get it.
This is how you treat tourists.
Like, yeah, we keep the immigrants safe.
I like it.
Yay!
It tastes like. Somebody raped a bubblegum soda. That's what it tastes like. It's that bad.
Yeah, that's a fair description.
That's why I like it.
Can I get some haggis juice instead? Like just...
We've got freshly squeezed haggis back in the bar's face.
I'm going to try one more time.
Okay, so that's...
It's so
empty.
That's fucking terrible. Wow. You got to actually... I will show you the thing that Cecil does. He doesn't like a food or a drink because Cecil's a foodie. A lot of people don't know. He's actually a culinary trained chef. So the thing that he does if he really doesn't like something is he does this. He goes, that's not for me. That's not for me.
He does that every time he eats at my home.
That's not for me.
So I'm raising up for you then. No.
This is.
Can you pronounce it again?
Iron brew.
No, that's not the word iron. Iron has an O.
So okay, now I got a serious question. Is this supposed to be an energy drink or like
a
soda?
That's a good question.
It's a soda.
It sells more than Coke in Scotland.
It really does.
It sells more than Coke?
Yeah.
It's marginally more, but it does.
I wasn't listening.
Is it legal to give to children?
It's made from what?
Made from gatos. Do you know what? We could be here all fucking night trying to explain that. Come on.
What are gatos? Those are chickens, right?
Cats in Spanish.
He's referring to an advertising campaign from the 80s, which was showing your age for a start, sir.
Let's go with those deep
cuts. Okay, I went for the, you know, it's fizzy, it's ginger, it's phenomenal. That was the last.
Ginger?
Is this supposed to taste like ginger?
No.
Ginger meaning orange.
Yeah.
Ginger meaning orange.
Let's
have that again, sorry.
Ginger means a fizzy drink.
Ginger means a fizzy drink.
But you already are using the word fizzy.
Take,
ginger just means drink, then.
Take me there. Take me there. How do? Because I know ginger means people with red hair. I know ginger means that root that you grow in the ground.
Yep.
Yeah? Take me how we got from those two to fizzy drink.
Okay.
Are we doing
ginger beer?
Yeah.
All right. I get it.
So, to do with the color more than anything else, right?
But
the term ginger just eventually evolved to meaning any kind of soda we call ginger now.
That is.
You don't need to know that.
That is unpleasant.
All right.
We call it
juice. Because juice. That is our idea of fruit juice.
Yeah.
This is a variety of fruit juice.
Have you ever heard of it? So when the do you guys have nutritionists and stuff, and they're like, get fruits and vegetables, and then your children turn to you and you're like, you call this a fruit juice? And then you're like, good point.
Wait, you haven't heard of the iron brew tree? Yeah.
I would rather have scurvy than another can of this. That's.
It's better with ice though.
No.
I asked.
Yeah, if you had enough ice, then it watered it down to where it was an ocean, and you put one drop of this.
I hear it's great homeopathic. It's really fantastic.
If you guys are hungover tomorrow morning, you'll be strangely craving that, okay? All right, where do you want to go next, James?
That is diabetic.
Is there a Lagavulin category?
I want to go with book review. I'd like to choose book review, please.
Book review, okay. Well, it's more...
Why are we letting Eli pick things?
Yeah.
It's fine, it's all right.
I'm in the middle!
So this is kind of a story so far, and we're looking for you guys to give us some input. Potentially, sorry?
It's not David Knight's book, is it?
Excellent.
The sad case point for the man in the second row. Well done. All right, Kim.
There, he gets it. He gets it.
So, at the moment...
Oh, you got the title wrong. It's called The Most Much Secret. The Most Much.
Tom and Cecil are currently on the podcast working our way through David. Does anybody remember the good old days when David Icke was just a shit sports journalist? Yeah.
Then he decided he was Jesus, right? And then he quit, and then that was real hard, because they killed that guy. So.
All right. Eli, Heath, and Noah are currently working their way through the Quran.
Which is a great book that we love a lot. Religion of peace, and it's well misunderstood. No, it's a shitty book. It's terrible.
So, gentlemen, for each of your books, can you tell the audience the story so far? You're not at the end yet, right? You're still three quarters of the way through. All right, give us a story so far.
Oh, holy shit. With The Most Much Secret from David Icke. All right, the story so far. We are 250 pages in. It's mostly a list of places and names. That's mostly what it is.
Stuff that he found in an encyclopedia.
Right, it's just a list. But I guess if I were to bottom line this for you, it's here's his summation. He believes that the world is run by a race of secret lizard people from the fourth dimension who are here.
No, they're also lower from the lower fourth dimension, the Draco constellation, and inside the Earth.
Yeah, they're from all they're from all of those at the same time, depending on what he
what
said
chapter
at that moment. At that moment, yeah. And they're here to take over the Earth, but they've already done it, but they're going to still do it more later, kind of just better, but slower somehow. And they want to do that so they get our monoatomic gold,
right,
which will give them superpowers to take over the world, which they've already done, but they're going to, again, continue to do it more much later. I'm sure it's got an incredible ending. An incredible ending. They're going to tie up all the loose ends.
Yeah.
I'm looking
for... It's like Lost.
You're really selling it. Okay.
Oh, it's great. It's great.
The Quran so far, gentlemen?
Muhammad is awesome, and he really wants you to know it. He's the best writer. You can't write better than him. The story of Moses 874 times in a row.
Yeah.
A bunch of soup... related descriptions of hell.
Yes.
It's all soup related.
Really hot soup, though.
Yeah, the soup will be super hot. And then he forgets for 10 minutes and, like, punches a wall in his cave. And then he comes back and he's like, I'm talking hot. This soup, you won't even taste it. It's the kind of thing that ruins your whole meal. And then he justifies a bunch of terrible things.
Yeah.
And then he fucks a 9-year-old.
And
he doesn't do that in the book, but yeah.
Kill Jewish people.
And kill Jews. Oh, he hates the Jews.
And it's also the worst apologetics you can possibly imagine. Because it's the God of the Gaps argument, but it's frozen in time, right? So it's like the God of the Gaps from like 600 AD or whatever. And he goes like, he says, I get in trouble for that at Skeptics. It's like 600 CE. But he'll go like, well, if there's no God, then how do you explain boats? Rain, you know, shit like that.
In the last chapter we read, his last apologetic was, if there's no God, how come the sky is all one piece?
Yes.
It is. It's all one piece. You can't argue with that.
It would be wrinkly in an atheistic world, but it's all smooth now. So, yeah. That's
excellent. Okay, so based on the story so far, we need to decide whether you would read The Biggest Secret or The Quran if you're next read. So hand up for David Icke.
Yes. No, you're all wrong. Oh. It's literally terrible.
Hand up for The Quran.
Really?
Yeah, actually. Right.
Some people are like, fuck that, no way. Trevor, you've already read The Quran, have you not?
Half of it.
Oh.
Have you read David Icke's book?
No.
I'm probably the only person in the room that's read both of them.
I've read that.
Oh, you have? All right. Yeah. And notice we both had our hand up for David Icke. I'm just saying.
You get a whole chapter on tantric sex in David Icke's book. I mean, you have to picture David Icke doing it.
Here's the thing.
I'm going to have this iron beer instead. I'm going to drink more of the iron. No, I'll go with tantric. Okay.
But
I don't know what to do.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Icke.
David Icke. What you get with David Icke is different chapters. Right? Like the next chapter will be, you know, have different words and a new order. And you get to missing that when you're reading the Quran.
Right. Okay. All right. Let's move on before we say anything else. All right. What do you guys want next?
Religion in Scotland.
Okay.
Book review.
Okay. So I think I've got a couple of multiple choice questions here. Let's see if it works. All right. Okay. So. I'll give you some multiple choice options here. Okay?
What is a footballer?
Yeah, okay. So,
football. Sounds fucking hot.
Football here is what you guys think of as soccer, not
I don't ever think of soccer. No one ever thinks of soccer.
Yeah, so your football is like our rugby except for pussies. So football.
Yeah, keep reaching.
Yeah, yeah, and 16 times the injury rate.
Yeah,
I must. Yeah, we kill our players.
So,
actually, our players kill other people.
Footballer
themselves.
Only their wives.
A lot of themselves.
So footballer Paul Gascoigne received death threats for playing an instrument. Was it
skin flute?
The air guitar.
Whoa. Am I right?
The air flute.
Oh.
The air drums or the air saxophone.
Go, Tom. Well, I guessed randomly by making a dick joke. Air flute, which that has gotten me into all the best and worst situations of my life. Actually,
Is the correct answer? There's Paul Gascoigne there playing the air flute.
Okay. Wait.
Who fucking chooses the air flute?
One of your professor athletes did a good thing, and then to celebrate, he was like,
Jethro Tull. All
right, and everyone was like, that shit's serious. I'll kill you.
Yeah, see, now that's the missing part of this story.
You need to
A, why do they send him death threats? And B, why is this in the religion and category? And I feel like those are related. So.
We're gonna tease this one out very slowly, okay?
They all say that, actually.
Okay.
Never believe him.
Not while me and Tom are here.
So he scored a goal and he played the air flute. Now,
it's so weird.
Paul Gascoigne played for Glasgow Rangers.
You are amazing at the
And he scored the goal against Glasgow Celtic, okay, which is the rival team. So we're telling you about earlier on. Now,
which team's better?
It was Celtic.
Can you stop making people mad? Can you stop?
Use more racial slurs.
Do you want to fucking black up the next time you come here? Jesus.
No, right. No, no. You're not even on my show. No. No.
Whiteboard.
Okay.
Get the leash.
All right, so can someone from the audience explain why pretending to play the flute is a bad thing?
Because you wanted to play the bagpipes?
No, it's just I live next to him.
All right, okay. Anyone?
Was it you? Were you the death threater?
The orange walk is the correct answer, okay?
Oh, that helped. Yeah, okay. No, okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. Right wait, first nice of all, late. That's a racial slur.
Wait, because of an orange walk?
The orange walk.
The first walk. Person to drink an iron brew.
For Chinese food. For Chinese food, the orange walk.
It's definitely not an iron brew festival, okay? So
God, that would be the most depressing festival ever.
It already sounds depressing.
Everybody just gets diabetes and kills themselves.
So every year, round and about the 12th of July, many Protestants in the city of Glasgow and across... What?
Something about a spigot. He said something about a spigot.
Sorry, I mispronounced bigot. Yeah.
Many baguette. Delicious French
bigoted fox in Glasgow will go for a lovely walk around the streets and play flute music to commemorate... The Battle of the Boing, yeah.
Which, the Battle of the Boing.
Is that real?
It's a real thing. You can, and the year was 1690.
It was just a fist fight. That's all it was. The Battle of the Boing.
Okay, now, who won the Battle of the Boing?
King Billy.
King Billy. Okay.
What is happening?
This is the War of the Roses. I know this. I don't know why it's upsetting.
In 1690, King William of Orange.
We don't even have a 1690 from where we're from.
Yeah. One.
But nobody would commemorate something.
A very important battle still. Against King
James.
We would not know the difference. You could say literally anything. Yeah. It'd be like giant bugs. We'd be like, oh, really? Tell us
but
about the giant.
If we boil it down into its simplest terms,
that's
a lot
American.
Of Protestants killed a lot of Catholics.
In Ireland, not in Scotland.
Okay. So the Protestants every year do a little march to commemorate the Battle of the Boyne.
Since 1690, they haven't fucking let this shit go. Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah. Since 1690, I'm still mad about something that happened in 1690.
No. They want you to do the opposite side of that joke.
I don't care. I'm going to yell about what I'm going to yell about.
So... So as the Protestants walk through the streets playing their lovely flute music, it tends to annoy the Catholics. Now, in football terms, taking again simplistic look, Glasgow Rangers are predominantly supported by Protestants, and Glasgow Celtic are predominantly supported by Catholics.
Your teams have religious?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, really?
Oh, that's
a thing.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh, that's a thing.
That's huge. Yeah,
yeah. Okay.
That's a thing.
This is the only time you've ever known something I didn't know. You're living it up.
All right. So the first time that I was on Skype with you guys and I made funny jokes about not getting your head kicked in, okay? If you wear the wrong colour in the wrong pub, that's when you get your head kicked in Glasgow. Is that fair?
Yes.
Which pub is
that
this?
Today? Is that today?
What colour?
Which pub is this?
That's kind of mission critical, guys. We need to know the colour.
Don't worry, like, you'll be out here tomorrow morning, you'll be safe, you know? But there are two similar teams in Edinburgh,
it's
but they're not quite as fighty as the Glasgow
it's
ones.
It's fighty.
No.
It's fighty. Your teams are fighty?
Yeah. Well, the supporters of the teams, yeah. Sure.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, there you go.
So anyhow.
I'll give them all an Airbnb and settle them down. Here we go.
Paul Gascoigne scores a goal against their arch rivals.
And
celebrates
murdering
this.
A bunch of them in 69.
Yeah.
I get getting pissed about that.
It's worth mentioning that he's English. He's not, you know, in any way. But he was kind of fooled by his teammates into doing that. They said, you know.
Wait, are you serious? They tricked him into doing it? They said,
that
go do this. That'd be super
such
funny.
An Eli move.
That's amazing. They're still mad. It's been 326 years. They'll love it. It's great. It's fun.
Yeah, but there was a story, like apparently as well, he got threats from the IRA.
Holy
well.
Shit!
Yeah, totally. So
I beat
that,
the shit out of my team.
That
mate.
Is a
oh
fucking long torture story about why that goal celebration is affected by religion in Scotland. Whew. Well, thank you, audience. Yeah. Well done. Well done, Jessica Sales.
They got the question right.
Okay.
I keep reaching for this iron brew.
Let's see which of these statements is false. Firstly, by law. Every local authority education committee in Scotland must reserve 3 seats for church appointees.
That sounds true.
50 pupils at a school in Scotland were recently given detention for refusing to attend Mass.
That sounds true.
And 8% of all state-funded schools in Scotland are religious schools.
That's a false one.
Yeah, I was thinking
it's
the same
be
thing.
Higher.
Stop taking this seriously. We're a comedy show.
You're just mad because you're losing.
Oh yeah, we were keeping points. Are you still keeping points, Graham?
Yeah.
Yeah, let the guy in the fucking Scathing Atheist shirt keep it.
Yeah. He's wearing the shirt of
the
team that's winning.
He also did
the
name tags. Yeah. Kidding.
He's like the East German Olympic judge. Everybody gets a 2.
So your guess is C, yeah?
That would be my guess.
Yeah, it's correct answer.
It's 100%.
That's what I thought too.
What instrument am I allowed to celebrate with? I'm worried to go for a air guitar and all the women in the just come up in the front stab me in the chest. After St. Battle's Day, really? Madeline Burnsberry was just taken from us! You heartless bastard!
It happened at 11:06, we're still fucking pissed about it.
Yeah, you're correct. C is false. It is actually higher, you pair of fucking smartasses.
Yeah.
It's about like 14%, but that's according to Wikipedia. You can correct me if you want. All right,
100%
microphone. Yeah.
It's 100%.
Go on.
No such thing as a non-religious school in Scotland.
Okay, insofar as...
Well, it's not the non-denominational schools. That's still...
Helpful skeptic over here.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's gross.
Yeah. Okay. Specifically with the first one though, option A. I'm going to invite Megan up just to explain that one a little bit further.
Oh, hi.
Yeah.
Megan.
Yeah. Megan.
Am I talking into it? Yeah, I mean, I know I'm talking into it.
I get it.
Okay, so local authority education committees are actually the Scottish version of the school board. And the way that works is they have seats where local MSPs, which are Minister of Scottish Parliament, and others can get elected onto the board, except the church appointees. They reserve 3 seats that have to be filled by the Church of Scotland, the Roman Catholic Church, and then a third option that's reflective of the religious atmosphere, I think is the term, in the statute, and which is more often than not Church of Scotland, or, and then secondary Roman Catholic Church. And so actually, we're actively petitioning to get them their seats up for democratic election instead of being automatically appointed. The Catholic something or another of parents, and I'm so sorry because I just found out, fully support us. So, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you. Round of applause again for me. And much more important than your applause, if you haven't already signed the petition, fucking sign it, okay? And tell friends to sign it and share it, okay? This is one of those, like, bullshit petitions that you see on change.org, like a fucking plaque for Harambe or shit like that, okay? This one,
you might want to use a different example, like one that's less important. To your guests. Harambe's like our flute, okay?
And it happened. The hill we die on.
It happened way recent.
I didn't realize Harambe was the Princess of Hearts in America. Okay. All right. But yeah, sign it. Tell your friends to sign it. And, you know, we'll actually try and do shit here, okay? Thank you. All right, cool. Do I have one more? Oh, I'm not sure if I did. I can't remember. Oh, yeah. Okay. So just a follow-up for this, all right? Can you guys decipher this at all?
Sitting on a floor.
It's in the Baltic Sea.
And singing Jesus songs when you weren't even religious. Because your schools are all so religious that you had to sing Jesus songs even if you weren't religious. It's like a throwback Thursday. They did that instead of the parachute game. You know how we had the parachute?
I'm still stuck on Wernie.
I'm still stuck on Baltic.
okay, all right. Any guesses for the word Baltic?
Don't guess, Heath. Don't guess. It's a trap.
Doesn't mean Indians. Okay, anyone? No?
Shitty?
Is it balsa wood?
Oh, you were so close. No.
It's a drug. It's a drug.
Cold. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. Wait, so Baltic.
Baltic means cold.
Oh, yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay. All right. And Wernie? Bear in mind what you saw earlier.
Wait, is Wernie something even, you would really write down?
Even, yeah, exactly.
It says even.
Yeah, no, I get that. I get that phonetically.
No, they don't have apostrophes here.
They lost them all in the Battle of Crowland. And if you do the air drums, they'll let you know.
You have to do the air apostrophe.
All your real words lost in a peat bog somewhere.
So, yeah, from the audience, hands up if you sang hymns at school when you were a kid. Yep,
holy
good.
Shit.
Jesus.
Keep your hands up if you gave a flying fuck what you were singing.
He gets it.
Okay. That's pretty indicative, yeah. Everyone sing or pretends to sing the hymns and then recites a Lord's Prayer at assembly each morning.
Yeah, we call that the National Anthem or the Pledge of Allegiance. We do the same shit. It's just hyper nationalistic.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's shimmy onwards. Okay, we've done that. Let's go back to the menu. Do we have anything? Oh, no, let's see. Dun. Oh.
Oprah or Chopra?
Fuck. Yeah. Right, okay. Let's do Oprah or Chopra.
This is going to be hard, actually.
I'd rather do Oprah, but not by a lot.
Yeah. All right.
Can I change my answer?
It's so like a fuck, marry, kill kind of thing.
Let's scrape the bottom of the barrel here, all right? So,
daily double.
Okay. So basically, I've got some quotes here, and I want you guys to guess whether it was said by Oprah or said by Chopra, okay? So we've got some hot Oprah on Chopra action there to start us off with, all right? Here we go. All right, so...
I changed my answer again.
The less you open your heart to others, the more your heart suffers.
That's Oprah.
We both.
Oprah? Oprah.
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 Let's find out. No, it's Chopra.
Oh!
Okay. Moving onwards. Number two. Passion is energy. Feel the power that comes from focusing on what excites you.
That's Oprah. That's Oprah.
I think that's Chopra, too.
That's Oprah.
It's the Eli Bosnick story. Right, let's find out.
Yes! Oh. Yes, knew it. I have that one on DVR.
Okay.
It's very inspiring. Then I will have a basket.
Be thankful for what you have. You'll end up having more. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you will never,
no.
ever
have enough. That's
Oprah.
Chopra.
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 Oprah. Oh, bro. Ah.
She's so fucking okay. rich.
She's so rich. How could she get away with that shit?
Okay. In the midst of movement and chaos, keep stillness inside of you.
Chopra.
That's a Chopra.
Yeah, there you go. Well done.
That's the first one we got right.
Okay, last one. Nothing is more important than reconnecting with your bliss. Nothing is as rich. Nothing is more real.
Oh, okay. Could
that be either?
I think it's Oprah.
Chopra.
I think it's a trick question. I think it's both of them. They said it at the same time.
In harmony.
Yeah. I'm going with Oprah. She's talking about being rich.
Yeah. Okay. It was not a trick question. That was Chopra. Oh, yeah.
Fuck.
Okay.
I'm
not
terrible.
Too bad.
Two.
Has anybody heard of the Wisdom of Chopra website?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's yeah.
Yeah,
great.
Okay. You guys. Okay. So
it's beautiful.
Do you want to explain where it is?
It's it's a much better random Deepak Chopra quote generator.
Yeah. Okay.
Because there was one for a long time that was just you see it five times you've seen everything, but also they've improved the hell out of it.
You're drinking that again.
Oh, it's really good.
You want mine forever. I keep reaching for it because it's here, and then I'm trying not to kill
myself. Well, that's it. I'm thirsty, and it's there. But
you can have it.
That's why
you can have all of them forever. I will buy these so that I don't have to drink them.
So yeah.
Buy stock in this company so I can shut it down.
Over the weekend at QED conference there, I met the guy who wrote the website. Yeah, just some random programmer who did it for shits and giggles one afternoon, and as you say, improved it recently. And it was used in a scientific paper recently. Anyone hear about that? Can you describe the paper, Noah?
No.
All right.
I already described the fucking website. I'm not doing your whole job.
Oh! He doesn't have any notes. He doesn't have any notes.
Okay, so it was a scientific study where they looked at people's propensity to look at those randomly generated statements and judge them on how profound they were. And they found out there was a correlation, this is very summary, correlation between people with lower IQ who found the statements more profound, okay? I.e. thickos are more likely to enjoy Chopra, you know, if you look at it in the nicest possible way. All right, cool. All right, that's us done for all of our segments, okay? So a round of applause for the panel.
I would like to know who won.
Graham. Who won, Graham?
Graham, who won?
I think you won personally, Eli.
Oh, you fucking suck up, yeah. Golf clap from Eli, yeah.
He always does.
Celebrate the air flute. Celebrate.
Oh, I almost did it because it was exciting and you told me to.
Can you do air harp?
Kazoo, man.
Air
bongos.
We're in Scotland. Air bagpipes.
Air bagpipes. That's safe, right?
Air bagpipes. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. There we go. It's not funny. Sounds like a funeral.
Okay. We've got time for questions. Any questions from the audience? Trevor?
I just want to give a fun fact about the wonderful Iron Brew. It was originally spelled correctly Iron Brew, but in the early part of the 20th century, there was a lawsuit about advertising because it's not officially brew. It's not technically brew.
Technically not iron.
So they
I know, right? It's neither of those things.
They changed the spelling and said, no, we don't brew it. We B-R-U it.
But well, why'd you get rid of
great
iron?
Great question, Trevor. Let me respond to that.
Sit in the corner. All right, okay. Gentleman towards the back there.
I'm sorry, there was at least one word there I didn't quite catch. You said, I'm happy to do what?
So, I've heard, listen, Skeptics for about a year, yeah? Mm-hmm. And I've heard you mention that previously you've talked about why you do the pseudonym thing, yeah?
Oh, yes, yeah.
So, do you want to talk about that at all?
Well, part of it is because Americans are crazy. But no, originally when we first started the company, or when we first started the show, Heath and I both worked for a company. It was a toy company. We were both like really public faces of it. We did a lot of work in religious schools and stuff like that. Mostly it wasn't the anti-religious thing we were hiding. It was the profanity and the sort of the vulgar nature of our show that we were hiding. I guess it was a little over a year ago when, I don't know, the 50th
atheist blogger in Bangladesh was murdered. I actually did put my I did attach my real name to the show. Started to feel a little cowardly in the safety of the U.S. Not having my name attached to the show, but I you know when you're 110 episodes in, you got to keep the name you've been using.
We had one of the Bangladeshi bloggers come to speak for us earlier. One of the alive ones.
They are much more entertaining speakers. Yes. They are. Yes.
Eli says, speak for yourself.
You're a monster, sir. A monster.
he was a fine speaker.
Well, it's a good thing Heath wasn't there because he has these words.
It was air piano. Don't do that.
You have no idea how many battles they've lost. It's gonna, we're going to die here.
Any more questions? Yes, front row.
Do you guys know the Skeptics Creed by heart? And could you do it?
No.
Credibility is not a virtue.
I don't know it by heart, but I would be happy to read it if anybody wanted to hear it. I'd read it.
I would rather hear Eli read it in your voice. That's just me.
Oh, that's super weird.
Yeah, I'll put it up on your phone. I don't get reception in your crazy moon country, so.
Okay.
Wait, maybe I do.
There was a live reading of it at QED. So a lesson for all of you would be to go to QED each year. It's the best skeptical conference in the UK and maybe wider. Fucking fantastic.
And it's better than any of them we have in the US as well.
QED was awesome.
It was really incredible. Amazing. Really incredible. I can't. One of the things that came up while they were pulling it up, I just wanted to throw out there, is we had three of the listeners to both of our shows who came over from Sweden. They flew over from Sweden because they'd never been to a skeptical conference, and they wanted to see us. And so they were talking about it, and I asked them, you know, be honest, like, have you ever been to a skeptic conference before? And she was like, no, we've never been to a skeptics conference before because we felt like skeptics just spend their conferences looking down their nose at people. And I've been to those conferences. I really have. I think we've all been to there where the guy gets up and he's like, homeopathy, right? Bullshit. And you're just like, yeah, man, that's my mom. Like, stop it. And so at the same time, but QED really had just an absolute excellent vibe. It was a community. I mean, people were mixing and mingling. Heath and Tom were up drinking with people until 5 in the morning every night we were there.
That's why I can't talk very
much.
Yeah,
exactly.
Right now.
But I mean, it was just an absolutely fantastic place to meet people. So if you haven't given it a shot, it's well organized, it's well worth the money, and it's an absolutely fantastic experience. As someone who's been to half a dozen, and no, you said you've been to 13.
Yeah, it was my 13.
It's the best I've ever seen, so I highly recommend it.
Excellent. Yeah,
it's awesome.
Yeah, I'm not on the staff, by the way. I'm on commission. More questions?
Were you going
to
do your...
Did you want me to read it for real?
Oh, yeah.
You got it right there?
I'm happy to do it if anybody actually wanted that. I can't understand that at all, but hang on.
Twice
to
do that.
Me. Yeah, you all, huh? Yeah.
No.
All right, we're going to help. One take.
You're stressingly good at that.
Jesus. Credulity is not a virtue. It's fortune cookie cutter, mommy issue, hypno-Babylon bullshit. Couched in scientician, double bubble, toil and trouble, pseudo-quasi-alternative, acupunctuating, pressurized, stereogram, pyramidal, free energy, healing water, downward spiral, brain deadpan, sales pitch, late night info docutainment. Leo Pisces cancer cures, detox reflex foot massage, death and towers tarot cards, I pronounce that tarot cars. I'm Scottish. Psychic healing, crystal balls, Bigfoot, Yeti, aliens, churches, mosques, and synagogues, temples, dragons, giant worms. He gets it. Atlantis, dolphins, truthers, birthers, witches, wizards, vaccine nuts, shaman healers, evangelists, conspiracy, doublespeak, stigmata, nonsense. Expose your sides. Thrust your hands. Bloody, evidential, conclusive. Doubt even this.
Yeah. It's like a greatest hit show now. Right? Cool. Okay, Graham, go ahead.
What would we have to do as an alternative that would make you drink Amber instead?
I'm sorry, what would we rather? Is this like a 30 seconds on the clock kind of a thing situation?
Yeah, more like a, instead of giving a movie $5 maybe.
Oh, gosh.
I really like it. I don't know. You've
been drunk for 3 days. That's, I would drink the same number of ounces of Clamato before I would actually. No, I might actually. I might need that.
I don't think they have that here.
Bad culture joke.
Damn it.
How about eggnog? Would you take this over eggnog? Oh,
hey.
Doesn't care if you don't swallow. Oh, hey.
I'm polite. If you commit, you commit.
I've licked Ray Comfort, so this is fine. It's fine. It doesn't taste as afraid.
It actually does taste a little like fear sweat. So.
Okay, second row. There you go.
It's a bit of an intimate question. I haven't mind that. So, Tom and Cecil, on episode 316, you both said...
It was a wizard.
You both said you picked Heath. If you had to pick one, it's going to be Atheist. I'm just wondering if that's changed or if it's still completely
new. Oh, yeah, we'd both call Heath.
Oh, yeah.
No. Actually, he's far more repulsive to be around in person.
Yeah.
Who would you pick?
For what?
To have sex with.
For intimate times.
Wait, you guys said you'd...
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Bashful kid.
Front and back, baby. Yeah. Fucking run right through you. Love it.
We do the human centipede.
It depends.
Eli's basically a human gummy worm, though.
Yeah, no, I'm sizing them up. It depends on whether or not we're doing oral because I feel like the beard would be a little.
Hold on, Tom, go like this.
Again? No.
Qualifying question.
Tom.
Am
Tom,
I on
Tom?
You don't need that. You don't need that.
Am I on top or bottom?
Bottom.
Bottom. I'm going with
bottom.
Tom. Because you want. You want it like he's mad at me. Like he's trying to get a nail in, but there's a stud underneath. You just...
You've never driven a nail in the head.
Because he seems to think that there's a stud underneath.
The idea of you with any kind of tool.
He's using the back end of the hammer, right?
You use the hammer straight up, and the weight helps drive it down. You use the wood.
And you just got to make sure there's no stud behind it and you're okay.
Exactly. Anna just comes and takes it from him. No. Let the men do it.
For a spoon, I'd pick Cecil.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, he...
Later.
All right, let's move quite clearly.
He's like choking down his food. Oh.
Wow, that's just like...
See, I've been able
Trump
to say
is America's
why Brexit. I've been able to deflect that with why Brexit up until now. God damn it.
Yeah. Comedy answer or serious answer?
Comedy first, serious answer.
Trump is America's id.
So...
Well, it's to get Hillary elected. It's the big conspiracy.
Yes. That's the... So the serious answer is that we made a terrible choice in our news when Roger Ailes created Fox News. We created this false fulcrum idea that there's the right... And there's the left, and then there's the middle. And the middle is the fair thing to do when it comes to news, right? So that the false idea we created was of the fair centrist news, fair and balanced news. That was what Fox News sort of sold to Americans a few years ago. And the idea was, you know, we've got a guy who thinks that lizards want our monoatomic gold, and we've got a guy who can see the world as it is, and we let them both talk for equal time, and then the light kills bad ideas, right, was the sort of idea at the time. And the problem is that what it really allowed people to do is only watch the parts of the news that they wanted to see. And because America's so fucking huge, I mean, it's giant, it's way too big, all of the TV...
Our country is way bigger than yours.
It's way too big.
We've had complaints.
From Native Americans. Yes.
But not for long. Not for long.
Or as Heath would call them, moo-moos. That's not a real racial slur.
No,
throw it around. Get it out there. Make it one. But all of our TV, all of our movies, all of our media, when it comes to entertainment, are about our cities, which made people who live anywhere but the cities in our country feel really ostracized and really like the media elites ignored them. And so that other side of the news that said the media elites existed sort of filled that gap for them and allowed that sort of I'm angry and I want my country back mentality to rise. And the problem is that we ignored that part of the country. We ignored education in favor of scorn. I mean, as much as we all love The Daily Show, y'all remember The Daily Show with Jon Stewart? Problem is, Daily Show only gave scorn to those ideas in that side of the country.
Big fan of scorn, though.
Yeah,
exactly. Let's not downplay scorn.
No. Scorn is very, very useful at times, but they only got scorn, and they created two sides in their mind, which allowed anyone who wasn't the media elite, which eventually yep. became the educated elite, which became people who can spell, sort of became the enemy to the extent that, again, the Trump supporter is not, unfortunately, the basement troll. It's the lifelong Republican who just does not see a difference between a political system that has never paid any attention to them. And what's terrifying is it was not... You know, the racists have always been there. They've always been like, bark, 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 and they've had signs and they play the flute. And we're always like,
don't do that again.
Yeah,
Jesus, man.
I'm so sorry.
I am not with this man. Yeah, different exactly. show. Get rid of this corner area.
They don't flute in our country, but the problem is they've always existed and they've always been this outlier. And at the same time, we've driven people who probably were more towards the middle towards that far right. And that gave rise to Trump. And more importantly, our media did it because we gave him, and there was a recent thing about this, we gave him 50 times the attention of some of the other candidates in that race. So we created him because... It's TV, and everything's TV'd up, Americans.
I just want to officially distance myself from almost everything he said except for that last like sentence or so. That was just all a really polite way of saying Americans are stupid racists, and someone was finally willing to engage the stupid racists on the stupid racists' terms. Because I honestly think the percentage of Trump supporters that you have the core of Trump supporters are... the bigots, the idiots, the people, the lowest common denominator in our country, and then we have just enough spillover of people who are like, my side is the right, goddammit, my side is the Republican side, but primarily it's because our country is filled with stupid bigots, and we're not willing to
not
admit
filled.
That as a country. And we're not willing to admit it, we're not willing to deal with it. I honestly think that is the primary reason for the Trump phenomenon.
But he's going to lose.
He's going to lose. He's going to lose.
He's going to lose because Noah's
really
wrong.
Big.
Hold on. He's going to lose because Noah's wrong.
Well, no, the polls aren't even close. If any of you are interested in American politics, look at Nate Silver's 538 election blog. It's the most accurate one. He got it down. He missed one county in the last election. He's going to lose everything that Mitt Romney lost. And then two other states.
It's not sure because we had polls that told us the breaks it wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, but they were fairly close.
They were fairly close.
These are not close. I will disagree with one thing that Noah said. America's not full of bigots, which is why Trump's going to lose.
America, by and large,
and I'm being semantic, but I think it's important because America's full of people that aren't going to vote for Trump.
Right.
Like, that's the more full side. That's the more much side, and it's a good side.
We're still embarrassed, horribly embarrassed.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no,
it's
we're
like
awful.
This panel. I'm
just
still on this panel, and it's terrible, but the rest of the people, if we voted for taking...
Well, if
bad
you think
apple.
About it,
bad
only
apple.
One of five of us has used a racial slur so far. It's indicative of the American
and I didn't even mean to.
Oh, now he's doing the air flu.
Neither is Trump.
Yes.
Yeah, the day is we've been gone for like 4 days. Could have happened.
I was going to avoid Brexit and Trump, but that's fine. We've done it. Let's move on swiftly before people get it. Yeah, okay, second row.
Have you had any British pizza yet?
Absolutely not. I'm going to stop you right there. I'm going to stop you right there. Absolutely not.
Have you had any British pizza yet? And is it worse than New York pizza?
Well, first of all, it can't be. It's literally physically impossible.
Has anybody been to New York and had pizza?
Is
it awesome? Is it not awesome?
That's their signature sauce.
The city, by the way. That's not the pizza.
That's just New York you're smelling.
That's just the garbage they pile outside. That's you can't tell.
That's
where else
are
you
going to
put it?
Have you had any British pizza, and is it worse than
Chicago
pizza?
No.
I love that question.
And yes.
What do you guys think about the Glasgow speciality of deep-fried
pizza?
We've had the pizza crust.
Oh, yeah. Well, I covered that very early.
I was told about that. So they make it. What about the Mars bar thing? Is that good? Is that good? I'm seeing nose it also.
It's exaggerated, I think.
Yeah.
On a scale from Iron Brew to 10.
are you done with that?
Yeah, sure, go for it. All right. You can have seasons too.
Yeah.
And have at it, bro.
While we're at it, there we go.
There we go, man. Chugs.
Excellent.
You will be diabetic when you're done with that.
All right. Hands up, any more questions? Yes, sir.
Yeah, for Tom and Cecil, because of the nature of the stories you cover, like listening to Cognitive Dissonance for me is like a cross between pissing my pants and banging my head against the wall.
Fair
and
enough.
There are times when I look at my MP3 player and go, oh God, not today. I just can't hear these stories today. And then the next day I'm in the mood and I'm rolling about the floor. Do you ever have days where you go, I can't even go through these stories?
I've had to walk away. What hits me is when kids die, and that happens with religion a lot. And so we'll get a kid died story, and it's not funny, and it just hurts, and you just gotta walk away. And I'll be doing the notes midweek, and I'll just walk away from the notes and say I'm gonna go do something else. I'm gonna go watch a movie with my wife or something else. But I can't. I just can't do it. And there's some stories that are so horrible that we don't even cover them.
Yeah.
That we just walk right the fuck away and say, forget it, this is not worth it. There's nothing interesting we can add to it. And that's something too, like we don't always just go for funny stories or something we can make fun of. No. There, if there's something interesting we might have to say, we may cover it, but sometimes there's things so horrible that you just say, I'm sorry, I just can't do that. We try to make it interesting or funny, but you know, once in a while, like you said, you'll look at the news lineup and you'll say, fuck that, and you'll put it away till tomorrow. Good for you, because you know, it's sometimes it's really hard to do.
Yeah, I'll say I never don't want to do the show because I love doing the show, but there are stories I don't want to do.
Yeah,
doing the show is it's a genuine pleasure to do. It's our hobby. It's what we love to do. So I'm always excited to go to the studio. I'm always excited to sit there and do the show. But sometimes, you know, like Cecil said, we'll look at a story and be like, no, and that goes into die now pile, and then you know, that's our souls mostly in that pile.
So, guys, a question for Tom and Cecil. You guys did your first live show at QED a few days ago.
Yeah.
How was the experience for you, and is it something you'd consider doing again?
So, Tom loves to be in front of other people and make jokes and kid around and stuff, and I'm kind of an introvert. So it was really an interesting experience, actually. We talked a lot about it, and we planned ahead, and we had a great show, and we had a really sympathetic audience, which is why I think it was a fun show. People were cheering and laughing, and then when they heard Hillbilly God, they all laughed, and so it really turned out to be a great show. I would do it again, and for an intimate audience, it's always awesome, because everybody just really wants to hear it. If they would have put us on the main stage there, though, and people were like marching out after our first F-bomb, it would have been a lot more awkward, so...
And let's move that on to Noah, Heath, and Eli. So you've done a couple of live Gamcasts. Is it something you're going to do more?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
We're even going to drag these guys on stage in January in Chicago.
That's right. We have a plan to
That's
be...
That's mind-shudderingly awful. I'm just saying.
We have a plan to be in Chicago in January. We have a couple other U.S. states.
That's right across the pond, guys. You could just come right on over.
Zip on over.
Tickets will be on sale, so just come right on over.
But yeah, we love doing live shows because, you know, to at least two of us, we started out doing stuff for live audiences. I'm a magician when I'm not doing comedy, and Noah was a juggler for many, many years.
And I'm terrified by doing live shows.
He's terrified by doing live shows, but he's still very good at them. So yeah, we actually love doing live shows. We want to do as many as we can.
Okay. And in your show, if you are describing someone who is overly officious or annoying in any way, you always characterize that person as being called Brian. Why is that?
So, the Brian meme started because there's always something so terrible in the movie that you have to imagine someone did it on purpose. And if you've ever worked on a movie or a film set, which I did a little bit of, there's always one PA or someone who's working in pretty much any official capacity who you're just like, how do you still have this job? I still have this job. And on my sets, it was always, and actually, it wasn't Brian. Yeah, it was me. But I blamed this other guy. In my sets, it was always, like, Brian always seemed to be a perfect name for him. Because you're always like, and so Brian always says, fuck you. That's Brian's catchphrase. It's always like, Brian, can you move the lights so that we can see the actors? Fuck you.
Is anybody named Brian?
Brian's named Brian.
So I want to point out, too.
Do you have a question or are you called Brian? Fuck. All right. There's not enough Brian's out there, okay? Yeah, okay. Yeah, let's move on before I get hurt. Go on.
Can Eli explain what a thunderstorm?
It's on the whiteboard. He's not allowed.
Yeah, Andrew told me I can't. Oh. He's our lawyer. It's a whole thing. Listen to the show.
That does lead on to an interesting question. So we've heard a little bit from Andrew on your recent shows, and is it something that you have to be particularly aware of now because you're getting more, I guess, more popular and more offensive by the week?
It's 90% a joke. We had one episode where I actually did commit the U.S. version of libel, which is much, much harder. It's much more difficult.
And he tries. You've got to be going out of your way to commit libel in the States, and still he managed it because he was going out of his way to do it.
So we literally had to put a little caveat at the beginning of the episode where it was like, hey, this is Andrew, the lawyer for Scathing Atheist and God-awful Movies. Eli's such a silly goose. He tells such silly jokes. Everything he says in this episode's a joke. Bing!
Oh, the Cristiano brothers.
Yes.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, all right. Yeah, it's much easier to get sued for libel in the UK, as Simon Singh found out to his peril. And again, at QED, we had Paul Zenon, the magician. He's currently or just working his way through finishing up a libel suit from some psychic or alleged psychic.
You guys also
A real psychic. A real psychic.
I have it all on tape.
You also have a winner-take-all legal system too, right? Which means that the loser pays everyone's legal fees.
Yeah.
So it costs you money to fight the lawsuit for a long time.
Yeah, absolutely. Even the winner, after they've paid, you know, they still end up losing some money as well, in general. So
this guy's literally just knocking down glasses one at a time.
Get that man some iron brew.
Okay, let's move on. Any more questions? Graham?
Are we recording the audio again, right?
Well, yeah, but since I've been fucking with the microphone and stuff, I don't know how it's going to sound.
Could we do a Father's Work
call? Oh, Jesus. As in you want the audience to do it?
Yeah. Well, no, so the way that we would have to do that is you would have to introduce yourself.
And them.
No. He has to introduce himself of the Glasgow Skeptics or whatever the name of your group is. And then everyone would have to say together, and we did, in fact, evolve from Filthy One.
Okay, so it would be Ian, Brian, and Ego from Glasgow Skeptics, and you guys would come in and see, and we did, in fact, evolve from Filthy Monkey Men. Oh,
that's a lot of words.
That's a lot of words.
If I don't have a chalkboard,
did you bring
the
teleprompter? Shit. This is gonna be bad. All right.
Go on the word page on the screen, you know.
Okay, so it's and we did in fact evolve from filthy monkey men. Hi, this is Brian from Glasgow Skeptics, and I'm happy to confirm that we. Oh yeah, that's right.
This takes the lead.
Oh, improv is good.
All right. I'll cut it down. Okay, so. Hi, this is Brian from Glasgow Skeptics. And we did, in fact, evolve from filthy monkey men.
Yeah!
Make a mental note. Scottish people can remember words. Good. Excellent. Oh, just while I remember, maybe not all Scottish people. Who's the person that came all the way from London? Yeah, stand yourself up.
Yeah! I just want to point out these guys came all the hell away from Chicago. So yeah, I mean to downplay that.
But you know that meant they got to leave Chicago, so you know,
alive.
Yes, yeah, so, big up to you, Hannah. All right. Apart from you guys, can anyone beat London? Anyone come from further than that?
Brighton.
Oh, yeah, all right. Round of applause. Okay. Wait.
You got the Draco
constellation? You're not like here on holiday or anything.
I was actually, but just for like a few minutes.
I take my clap back.
We withdraw that applause. Fucking bros.
I was going to say it, but she pointed at
me. All right. Yeah,
I'm actually from Brighton.
You'd never have guessed.
That's the most non-answer answer ever.
Sorry?
First time I've ever been
spotted.
Us too.
We very much much hope you make it home alive.
Don't play the air flute. Yeah, I just learned that. They're still butthurt about a thing that happened hundreds of years ago. Yeah,
and don't go past the antique shop as well.
Look right when you do. I'm
trying to put you on display. Right. Okay, any more questions?
Yeah.
Alex.
Look at recoil. Right.
So now there's two questions that you could be asking. Are you talking about like Ed Wood, Plan 9 from Outer Space, I love shitty movies? Or are you talking about genuinely a good Christian movie?
A genuine.
There is one good Christian movie I know of called The Apostle with Robert Duvall and Billy Bob Thornton. That is actually a really, really good movie. It's a really, really Christian movie. We will never review it on our show. It'd be boring as hell. But that actually is a really good movie, and it's a very religious message.
I liked Loving the Bad Man.
That was pretty good. But she didn't end up with the rapist at the end. They kind of pulled the rug out from under you. But
it's like Sliding Doors. Sad.
I've normally already committed to the movie by the time we announce it on the show, or by the time we've seen it, we've already announced it on the show. So there have been a couple of them we did where we were like, wow, that wasn't really as bad as we wanted it to be at all, is it? So, but there, I'm sure it may eventually happen that we watch one that's so good that we're like, okay, we can't do this. The odds are against it, though. I mean, I've seen hundreds of Christian movies now, and there's the one good one that I can name. That's it, so... Probably not something we have to worry about realistically.
We did find out recently one we had planned to do was done ironically.
Oh,
so
right.
We pulled it. Dark Dungeons. Has anyone heard about this? Yeah. It's the deep. But the filmmakers made it ironically. We checked out their website. I was like, I'm going to make fun of these motherfuckers. And they were like, look how stupid this is. We did it word for word. And I was like, oh, they're on our side. We're not talking about what they look like.
Okay. Any more questions? Not about Cecil's prostate issues. Yes.
Are you optimistic or pessimistic regarding the future?
I'm sorry, for what in the future?
Optimistic regarding or pessimistic future. Regarding, as in the
optimism or pessimism?
The religious outlook in the world, or just in general, sir?
Just in general.
No one's ever accused me of being optimistic.
We're a perfect trio because we've got pessimistic, optimistic, narcissistic.
Good, the bad, the ugly.
You want us too? I'm actually intensely optimistic about the future. Truthfully, I think if we take a long view of humanity, this is the safest we've ever been. You know, I mean, this is the people live the longest, have the highest quality of life. Not every person, obviously, unfortunately, but that trend is growing. And I think we've got some significant problems that we've got to face, but we've always had significant problems that humanity's had to face. But I think we have better tools to face them now than we have ever had before. And we have incredible things that help to democratize information and the movement of information and education, and those are the things that are going to build a better future for us. You know, the fucking interwebs, I hear really good things about. I haven't checked it out, but Cecil says it's real hard and we should do more of that.
I disagree. We're all gonna die. I'm right.
It is true. Yeah. There is a book. I think, is it Steven Pinker? Is it?
Yeah. Better Angels Over Nature.
There you go.
Yeah. Never heard of it.
If you ever want an uplifting read, I believe that is the one to go for after you finish reading either David Icke or the Quran. All right. Maybe time for one or two more questions. So let's make them good ones.
Unlike the shit we had before.
Yeah. Lloyd.
You look like you'd make a great band. Could you maybe give us a song?
Should we play the air flute?
I'm terrified. That's a trick question.
The five-part barbershop quartet, like I told
you.
Boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom.
Say, well, that's it.
That's it.
Looks like you call it Radiohead, but yeah. Something that harmonies will do.
No, you're a musician, right?
Kind of.
What'd you play?
Guitar, piano, and air flute.
Skin flute.
Yeah.
Once.
All right. Next one.
College.
Yeah, it's a good ball. Who can I consider the same kind of true belief, the true religion? Which one and why?
Oh, if you had to convert.
Like if someone's going to meet you outside and is going to convert you to your religion, what would you rather be?
Oh, I would say Wicca. There's more naked ladies in that one than the other.
Good answer.
Generally.
Good answer. Are they outside now? I got things to do.
There's a park nearby.
All right, okay. I think we better call it an evening, so can I have, please, a huge round of applause for the panel.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys.
Record club, different song.